And I was young and knew everything. Uncle really ever took advice. Now I'm guilt-stricken, sobbing with my head on the floor. A baby's breath and a shoe full of rice. Responsible. She was touching her face. I won't be held responsible. She fell in the first place. Meanest thing, rising we know. For the life, I cannot believe that I'm not for the season. We won't get
me, I say, well, I say, boom, 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 now we're about to say, well.
Hi guys, I cannot believe it's been 12 years since I had some of you in first grade. You have all grown up so much and turned into just such great young men and young ladies. I wish you all the best and good luck in whatever you choose to do.
I had Heather Bernhagen, Amy Sneed, and Bonnie Procaccini. And they were in with my first group of students, and they're actually graduating early this year. And I have a funny story to tell about Amy. I tell this to everybody. And we were having a Cinco de Mayo festival, and this was when we were at the other building. And my room was right there toward the end near the playground. And I was passing out food to everybody, and she had gone outside, and they come back in, oh my gosh, Miss Leger, Amy's joking. So I go outside, and she wasn't, I mean, she was breathing, she was coughing, she was not choking, but being my first year, I snatched her up, carried her, and ran straight to the office with her, thinking she was dying because she was choking. So, good luck, girls. I'm very proud of y'all.
Well, I want to say congratulations to the graduating class of 2003. Some of the kids that I had in third grade, it was my first year to teach 10 years ago, and a few of the kids that I remember are Amber Burnett and John Trammell, Julia Morales, Bo Dickerson, Christina Henderson, Saron Simmons, and quite a few others, quite a few that have moved away and have all grown up, and I still see a few around town. One of the most memorable moments I have was when Bo Dickerson brought a live snake into the classroom and said, "Look, Miss Rawson." Scared me to death, but he kindly took that back out and underneath our porch, I guess. Words of wisdom. Keep growing and keep learning and never give up. Congratulations.
This goes out to all the women of the world, especially her. You know it don't even matter your age. Don't even matter your color. Your fellas, I forget about y'all. This is where everybody like to hang. Just listen to what I'm saying and do it.
Well, seniors, I just want to let you know that I think the world of you, and you have the world at your fingertips. Congratulations on achieving this award. I remember that I had several of you in the third grade out in the portable buildings behind the old intermediate school, and I remember several of you children that are now adults, and some stories that come to mind, just the good times that we've had, and you guys, you know, be whatever you can be, and be proud of yourself, and I'm so proud of you.
Work hard. They never give up.
Your class, just follow your dreams. Dreams become reality once you follow them. I see the time when Destin McBlain was in my classroom and I was being evaluated. He was leaning back in his chair and I just told him to sit down. And I popped his chair and he fell out and busted his head on me.
Stay in college as long as you can, because working's no fun. And
memorable students.
All of y'all are memorable. Whitney and John were the hot couple that year. I do remember that.
Wisdom for the senior class of 2003. Be sure you cut your hair.
John Trammell received my Gnat of the Year award because Ollie and Owens, I think, was in on it too. Okay, got my Gnat of the Year award. Y'all drove me crazy. I'm glad you're leaving.
It's that last period of the day.
And y'all drove me crazy. It was all boys except for like two, three girls. And y'all made, it was insanity. And I yelled at you all the time. I can't wait until you go out into the big world. Get a job.
Watch out, here they come. Basically, the world in general. Go out and succeed. Be successful. Some of you are going to have to quit being so lazy. Bo, when he came to school with all his poison ivy and gave it to everybody. Cook, who slept the whole time through my class. And we won't even go to Lamont and Martin. Stood out, I would have to say, Bryce Hodge and Lacey Lanier are the two that stood out. Because Bryce was hilarious. His stories in his journals and that type of stuff. And Lacey just, you know, she was tall and everything, so everybody always looked at her and said, golly, you're tall.
What you've learned today, you use tomorrow. Every year got easier.
Go ahead. A few words of wisdom for the seniors. You know, always work hard, strive for your goal. Stay after your classes, go to class. And, you know, if you have a dream, follow it, maybe you'll see success. Most memorable students. I don't have any in particular students. I guess the most memorable students are those guys that have always worked hard, had a good positive attitude, and, you know, just been fun to be around.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it.
Now, usually I don't do this, but go ahead on, break them off with a little previews of the remix. Now, I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my electric school. That's why
you've got a friend in me.
You must be a football coach. The way you got me playing the field. So, baby, give me that. And let me get you that. Running her head through my fro. Bouncing on 24s. Why they stand on the radio? It's the remix to Ignition. Hot and fresh out the kitchen. Mama ruling that body. Got every man in here wishing. Sipping on coke and I'm like the water. I'm tipping. It's the freaking weekend. Baby, I'm about to have me some fun. Bounce, 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 bounce. Now it's like murder, she rolled. Once I get you feeling what you're feeling. No more hoping and wishing. I'm about to take my key and stick it in the ignition.
Words of wisdom. Don't be satisfied to be second best. Don't be satisfied with just a high school diploma. Try to get them, you know, you need to be educated your entire life. I like everybody in the class. You know, just some a little bit better than others. But I'll miss y'all when you're gone, seriously.
Best of luck to this class. There's a lot of special people in it, and I will always remember how wonderful you were. Good luck in everything you do, and just hang in there.
My favorite student is Dustin McBlack, the only student that majored in physics in his high school career. Not only that, he played monster for me in football. Just get better every day.
It's probably the best high school that I could ever work at because of the students, the sports, and the faculty that I work with. You can't get any better. Favorite boy student I'm going to miss the most is Bryce Hodge, the most creative student that I've had, because I've had a lot of creative students. Bryce, he sees outside of the box on life, and he's not narrow-minded.
Every Friday night, there's a steady cloud of dust that leads back to a field filled with pickup trucks. Got old Hank cranking way up loud. Got coolers in the back, tailgate's down. There's a big fire burning. Seen Becky all week. Somebody said they seen them headed down to the creek. Farmer Johnson's daughter's just pulled up in a Jeep. Man, he knows how to grow them if you know what I mean. Old Dave's getting loud, but he don't mean no harm. We're just country boys and girls getting down on the farm. You can have a lot of fun in a New York minute, but there's some things you can't do inside those city.
Back when I was young, couldn't wait to grow up, get away and get out on my own. And looking back now, ain't it funny how I've been trying to get back home?
flashing light. Nothing better to do on a Tuesday night. But give me hell. Where you headed? What are you out for? We don't see much of you around here anymore. I guess it's just as well. Once upon a time you had it all. You let everybody down. You're always 17 in your hometown. Running from your folks, running from the law. Running from love, running from your fears, running from it all. You keep on running, boy, you run yourself in the ground. You're always 17 in your hometown. Her porch swing still looks the same. She probably won't even remember my name. Looking back now, well, it makes me laugh. We were growing our hair, we were cutting class. Knew it all already, there was nothing to learn. We were striking matches just to watch them burn. Listen to our music just a little too loud. We were hanging in there with the outcast crowd. And man, I don't know where the time goes, but it sure goes fast. Just like that, we were wannabe rebels that didn't have a clue. T-shirts and our typically bad attitude. Had no excuses for the things that we've done. We were brave, we were crazy, we were mostly young. Young. Talked a good game when we were out with the guys, but in the back seat we were awkward and shy. Girls were a mystery that we couldn't explain. And I guess there are some things that are never gonna change. Man, I don't know where the time goes, but it sure goes fast. Just like that, we were wannabe rebels that didn't have a clue. And our rock and roll t-shirts and our typically bad attitude. Had no excuses for the things that we've done. We were brave, we were crazy, we were mostly young. Young.
and starting off, I had my senior as a sister, and we had a good time. Just it started off fun with having teachers like the Fever, you know, tear down freshmen and stuff like that, and all the way up through the years, doing sports and just being involved and everything. It was just all around a good experience all the way up until right now, right at the end. But I'm probably going to go to junior college, rock bat, and golf bases out of the way, because just in case I want to change my future goals. But for right now, I'm going to do that and then go to graduate school, seminary.
Start ITT, tech. Go there for 2 years to get my degree. And I don't know what I'm going to do.
My high school career was awful because I graduated last in my class. No, I was first in the class of 2003. High school was awesome. And I'm going to go on to UNT, and I'm going to major in radio, television, and film. And most people say they want to be the next Steven Spielberg. Well, I'm going to be the next Bryce Hodge.
Blinn Junior College and transfer to Texas A&M University. And I'm going to major in dentistry and be a dental hygienist.
Go to college and get my business degree. Thank you.
Oh, I'm going to try for the next one.
I'm going to miss my friends. Anyways, I'm going to ACU, Evelyn Christian University, and I'm going to major in nursing.
Within Wildcats.
Yep.
My high school experience was great. After school, I'm going to go to college and be a baseball player. And the thing that I'll miss is homework.
I feel blah, blah, blah about high school. No, actually, high school is fun when you're playing sports, but when you have to tuck in your shirt and you can't wear pajamas in the morning when we gotta be here at 11 o'clock, it really
and have to get a haircut with 3 days of school left.
Yeah, that too. It's really bogus. But I'm kind of glad it's coming to an end, but I'll probably cry myself to sleep again today.
I'm going to miss high school, I guess, just from being around all my friends and everything. They're pretty cool. And just everybody's pretty friendly. After high school, I'm going to go to UT, and then I'm going to take over.
My high school career was fun, exhilarating. It was filled with moments that I would want to do over again, like English. Some of my English classes, English tests that I had to take. But it's been exciting, it's been different, and I'm ready to move on with my life, and I'm ready to take what I've learned here and actually use it in the real world.
When I think back on these times and the dreams we left behind, I'll be glad, 'cause I was blessed to get to have you in my life. When I look back on these days, I'll look and see your face. You were right there for me.
A month ago, I don't like you.
The verse is, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And I'm telling you flat out, by the time you walk across that stage next Thursday night, we might even start to like you. And by the next time I see you after graduation, I think it's like a miracle, after graduation, I'll even treat you like a real person.
Life isn't fair, get used to it. Always remember who your real friends are. You will be missed. We do love you.